All right, so that's supervised learning and unsupervised learning. That's pretty good. The last one is reinforcement learning.
Woo!
Now, reinforcement learning is what we both do. So Michael does a little bit of reinforcement learning here and there. You've got how many papers published in reinforcement learning? All of them.
Several. I have several.
The man has like 100 papers of reinforcement learning or something. In fact, he wrote with his colleagues the great summary journal article bringing everyone up to date on what reinforcement learning was like back in 19...
Yeah, like 112 years ago.
1992.
People are saying, like, yeah, we should probably... Somebody should write a new one because the other one's getting a little long in the tooth.
But there have been books written on machine learning since then.
That's right.
It's a very popular field. It's why we're both in it. Michael tends to prove a lot of things.
That is not why I'm in it.
Why? Wait, what?
You said it's a very popular field, and that's why we're in it.
No. Did I say that?
That's what I heard.
I didn't mean to say that. It is a very
popular field.
Let's do that again because I did not mean to say that. It is a very popular field, perhaps because you're in it, Michael.
I don't think that's it. When I was an undergraduate, I thought the thing that I really want to understand, I liked AI, I liked the whole idea of AI, but what I really want to understand is how can you learn to be better from experience? And like I built a tic-tac-toe playing program, and I'm like, I want this tic-tac-toe playing program to get really good at tic-tac-toe. Because I was always interested in the most practical society impacting problems.
Tic-tac-toe generalizes pretty well to world hunger.
Eventually. So that was what got me interested in it. And I didn't even know what it was called for a long time. So I started doing reinforcement learning and then discovered that it was interesting and popular.
Right. Well, I certainly wouldn't suggest that we're doing the science that we're doing because it's popular. We're doing it because we're interested in it.
Yes.
And I'm interested in reinforcement learning because in some sense it kind of encapsulates all the things I happen to care about. I come from a sort of general AI background, and I care about modeling people. I care about building smart agents that have to live in a world with other smart agents, thousands of them, hundreds of thousands of them, some of whom might be human, and I have to build some way to predict what to do over time. So, from a sort of technical point of view, if we can think of supervised learning as function approximation and unsupervised learning as, you know, concise, compact description, what's the difference between something like reinforcement learning and those two, supervised learning in particular?
So often the way that reinforcement learning is described is as learning from delayed reward. Mm-hmm. So instead of the feedback that you get in supervised learning, which is here's what you should do, and the feedback that you get in unsupervised learning, which is the feedback in reinforcement learning may come several steps after the decisions that you've actually made.
So a good example of that, or an easy example of that, would be actually your tic-tac-toe program, right? So you do something in tic-tac-toe. You put an X in the center. And then you put, let's say, an O over here.
Ooh.
And then I put an X right here.
Nice.
And then you ridiculously put an O in the center, which allows me to put an X over here, and I win.
All right.
Now, what's interesting about that is I didn't tell you what happened until the very end when I said X wins.
Right. And now I know I made a mistake somewhere along the way, but I don't know exactly where. We may have to kind of roll back the game in my mind and eventually figure out where it is that I went off track and what it is I did wrong.
And in the full generality of reinforcement learning, you may have never made a mistake. It may simply be that that's the way games go. But you would like to know which of the moves you made matter. Now, if it were a supervised learning problem, I would have put the X here, he would have put the O there, and would have been told, that's good. I would have put the X here, and then when he put the O there, it would have been, that's bad. The O goes here.
Mm.
Or something like that, would have told him where he should have put the O. But here, all he gets is eventually some kind of signal saying, you did something well, you did something poorly. And even then, it's only relative to the other signals that you might have gotten.
Right. So then reinforcement learning is, in some sense, harder because nobody's telling you what to do. You have to work it out on your own.
Yeah, it's like playing a game without knowing any of the rules. Or at least knowing how you win or lose. But being told every once in a while that you've won or you've lost. Okay.
Now, sometimes I feel like that.